Hey, what is going on, everybody? How are you all doing today? I hope you all are having a wonderful and fantastic day today, and if not, hopefully you all will have a better tomorrow. So, today we are going to discuss another semblance and rate it, and that would be Raven Bronwyn's semblance. How powerful is this semblance exactly? So we're going to look over the abilities of what Raven can do with this semblance, and then rate her overall semblance. So sit back, relax, I hope you all enjoy, and let's go ahead and get started. So, Raven Bronwyn, one of the members of Team Stark, we are now going to look into her semblance. Her semblance is known as Portal Creation, and as we did see for the very first time in Volume 2, Raven was able to create a portal to save Yang from Neo when Neo was about to kill Yang. And from then on forward, we hadn't seen it for a while up until Volume 4, whenever Raven talks to Crow. But how these portals exactly work is that Raven's semblance allows her to create portals to instantly be able to travel from one place to another from the people that she is bonded with. So if Raven is bonded to an individual, such as, like for example, when Neo was about to kill Yang, she had a bond with Yang being her daughter. Therefore, she was able to create a portal to go to actually save her life at the last instant. So, as long as Raven has a bond with an individual, she can go from one place to another, and this travels to very far distances. So, Raven can be on one side of Remnant, and then because she's on one side of Remnant, say if somebody else is on another side of Remnant, she can actually just create a portal, and she can warp from that place to where that person is, and if she is connected to a person that she warped from the said location, so let's say Vernal was alive, right? She used Vernal from the camp to go back to where she was. So if she traveled from, I guess you could say, where Crow was, like we saw in Volume 4, and then she warps all the way back, well, that tells you that as long as she has a bond between one person to another, she can warp the portal. But the thing is, if Raven does not actually have a bond with an individual, she cannot warp to them. Hence RWBY, for example. Raven would never be able to warp to RWBY directly through RWBY because she has no bond to RWBY. Therefore, if Yang or Crow is present, then she would be able to warp to RWBY. And unless she formed a bond with RWBY, then there would be no way she could actually directly go to her unless there is somebody she is bonded with is there. So, the semblance in itself is a bit of a tricky one, because if Raven's warping to somebody, she obviously doesn't know directly where they are until she comes through the portal. So she could make a portal to somebody, and for all she knows, they could actually be in a fight, and then she could come in the middle of a fight that's going on. But then again, you never know, because like I said, she has no idea of where they're going to be. She just creates the portal, and there she goes. But at the very same time, we do also know that her portals actually can help in another way too. So they don't just work for her, because if Raven chooses to, Raven can also send other individuals through her portals. Now we did see this in Volume 5 at the Battle of Haven. She did send Cinder and everyone else through the portal. And that was because also she was bonded to Vernal, therefore she was able to open a portal into Haven, thus allowing Cinder and everyone else, including Vernal, to go through the portal. So, as long as there is somebody that she is bonded to on the other side of the portal that she's trying to send them through, like with Vernal, for instance, then she can send other people along with Vernal through that portal. Now, one thing that could have been very interesting, I think, because we've never seen it used within an actual offensive reason, I mean, other than we do know that projectiles and things can go through the portals, considering we did see a fireball from Cinder go and hit RWBY whenever Cinder came through the portal. So, there's that, which I still question how Cinder knew RWBY was there, but yeah, whatever. Anyways, moving forward, we've never seen this actually used offensively other than that. So for all we know, Raven, if she had fought alongside somebody like her teammates, for example, that she has a bond with, maybe Crow, because, well, Tai Yang hasn't battled in the series at all yet that we've seen. I mean, of course, we know that he was a huntsman, so he had to have fought at one time, but currently, we've never seen him fight as of the recording of this video, so maybe Summer could have actually fought with this portal. She could have actually seen Crow or strategized a plan with him, maybe, and maybe they could have fought together, and Raven could possibly warp through portals, sending, obviously, Crow or herself through them to fight, but like I said, that is just me theorizing because we've never seen this happen. So, because we've never seen this happen, I can't say that it can, I can't say that it can't. But if it were to be used within an offensive strategy, I think that would be interesting to actually see. But considering that we never did see an interaction between Raven and an ally like Crow or anyone else that she was bonded with, we have no idea if she's able to do that. But I would imagine maybe so. But like I said, this is just a theory, so we have to throw that completely out of speculation. So more or less, if anything, all we know is that she's able to send people through portals whenever they're bonded. So whether it can be used in combat is really up to question. But with all of that aside, looking at how Raven has actually used her semblance, we've seen it really used more for supportive reasons and not really offensive ones. So that leaves Raven to really more so rely upon her own skills rather than her own semblance in combat, because Raven can't just have a portal pop out in the middle of nowhere just at any time, anywhere. It doesn't work that way. She has to be bonded to somebody. So because of that, it really does cut down on the utility of how this semblance can actually be used. So, what would I rate this semblance on power? Well, it's a tier 3. This is a novice level semblance because of everything we've seen and how the semblance has been used, it's only been used for transport reasons. Now, while that's not a bad thing, it's still very limited because Raven has to be bonded to somebody to be able to make a portal and go from one location to another. So if she had nobody in her life, let's say she was bonded to no one, her semblance is entirely useless. She can't use this semblance at all whatsoever. Therefore, meaning she has to have a friend or someone close to her for this semblance to be able to be used. Otherwise, it is completely dead as a semblance. It's as if she's like Mercury at that point. She has no semblance, pretty much. So for her to be able to use a semblance, she has to be bonded to someone, and that really limits the use of it, because if she could fight with somebody that actually was bonded with her, then maybe we could see her actually use portals during the fight to transport herself or the other person through while attacking the enemy. Now, that could have been really cool, and that definitely would make this semblance much higher on the tier scaling, but overall, with how limited this semblance is and how much we've only seen of it, which is very little at best, yeah, this semblance is very low on the scaling, and unfortunately, Raven can't really use this very well unless she's just going from location to location, as I stated. And would I like to see an actual fight with her, fighting along somebody that she has a bond with in the future, and using this, and maybe being able to throw people through that she's bonded with, and throw herself through while fighting? That would be awesome, but overall, this semblance isn't very good. I think it's actually one of the worst semblances. Now, unless it evolves and she can just go through willingly without having to be bonded to someone, yeah, that would be amazing. But, I mean, it still has some utility, so it's not completely useless, but it has huge limits that stop this semblance from being better than it actually is. So that's why it's a tier 3 semblance. But anyways, let me know what you think down below. Do you agree? Do you disagree? Let me know in the comments down below. But anyways, thank you all for watching. I hope you all enjoyed. And if you did enjoy, hit the video with a like. Subscribe if you want to see more content like this. Share this video with your friends if you found this informative or useful. And follow me on Discord. The link is in the description down below. But anyways, I hope you all have yourselves a wonderful and fantastic day today. And remember, if today was not a good day, tomorrow could always be better. Take care of yourselves and everyone around you. And have yourselves a good one out there, everybody.